to Chris Grant. What a heritage, what a lineup.
But there is only one name to add. I'd like to welcome David Smorgon and Rodney Eade back to present our second legend, sponsored by Cougar. And if there's anybody in the room who doesn't know who it could be, I suggest you leave now.
Now we've got our backs against the wall and we're going to fight, and we're going to fight hard. It's going to be a do-or-die effort. It's going to be a determined bit. You've got to show me all the guts and all the determination you've got in your body. You've got to inspire me with this last quarter bit. You've been in front all day and you've got to stay there. Are you going to sit there?
When the Australian Football Hall of Fame was announced in 1995, one man, above all others, was elevated to automatic legend status. Mr. Football, Ted Whitten. And there was not a murmur of dissension. Let Mike Brady take up the story.
Now tell me, Mr. Whitten, Mr. Football, if you like, did you ever give some back chat to the little man in white?
Never talked an umpire in my life except to say g'day.
Tell me, Teddy Whitten,
Mr. Football, if you like,
did you ever whack the enemy when the ball was out of sight?
Hey, you've got the wrong bloke. I only whacked them when the ball was in sight.
Teddy, EJ, Ted all sounds like football to me, Teddy, EJ, it all sounds like football to me.
Now tell me, EJ Whitten, did you ever let one rip? Did you ever help them lift their game by using the monkey grip?
Don't ask me. I wouldn't know a monkey grip from a squirrel grip.
Tell me, Mr. Football, was there a fight you'd ever miss? And didn't you give the gummy shark a hug and a farewell kiss?
No, no, not me. I was just trying to get the mud out of his mouth.
Teddy, EJ, it all sounds like football to me.
The deeds of Ted Whitten are the stuff of boyhood dreams. The local lad who played a record 321 games, was captain in 212, was coach for 228, five best and fairests, and a starring role in the club's only premiership. Captain of the Bulldogs team of the century, and in 1996 anointed captain of the AFL's greatest team in 100 years. And as he fought his last great battle, the nation prepared to mourn. Tonight, 15 years after we said farewell, we proudly induct Ted Whitten as an inaugural legend in the Bulldogs Hall of Fame.
Ah, Ted, I just want to say before I say anything, you're here representing EJ, but over on the table over there, I had a chat to his brother Don, his sister Edna, the family, and what a family it's been through this football club. And you enjoyed it as well.
Yeah, I have, Steve, and it's great to have Uncle Don and Auntie Edna here tonight, and my children and my wife. It's probably one of the greatest nights that you know, I would have had looking after Dad and what he's done in his life, and it's just great to be here with the Bulldogs and all the supporters and everyone who's played with the club and been supporting the club over all those years.
I doubt if there's one person in this room who has not been touched by Ted in some way or other, as a player, as a coach, as a mentor and mate. He left an indelible impression at this football club.
Yeah, I think you're right. The Footscray Football Club, the Western Bulldogs, was Dad's life. He loved the players, he loved the coaches, he loves the supporters, the boot starters, the trainers. He loved all the people from the western suburbs. The whole club was his life. And I think he represented the club fantastically over his career and his life. And at the end of the day, you know, he's played 321 games and it was all about the Bulldogs and all the people who supported them.
Teddy, for you, it was an enormously hard act to follow. That was well documented. But he was enormously proud and a great support as you started making your mark at the club he loved.
He was. He followed me all over my career, my junior career, and it was a bit tough early days following him. And I always knew that, you know, I wasn't going to get anywhere near his career. But it was great to be able to follow his footsteps and eventually play for the Bulldogs and represent the family. And the red, white and blue was what it was all about. And, you know, to be able to go and play with the Bulldogs and follow his footsteps was a great thing for me.
It didn't really need the lap of honour at the MCG or the outpouring of grief at the state funeral to understand what Ted meant to Victorians. Did it surprise the family a little to just see the whole thing unfold at the end?
I guess so. But you know, look, it was when he passed away, the funeral and the cortege going back to the ground and the amount of publicity that. That happened through it was just amazing. It was absolutely amazing from my point of view. And look, as a young fella growing up, I always knew he was a champion footballer, and I knew he was a champion dad. But what happened at that funeral, and you know, even though I'd followed it all through his career, and I knew how big he was, a bigger name he was in football, what happened that day from football lovers in general, and particularly the people from the western suburbs, was unbelievable.
Well, Ted was always the life of the party, and tonight, 15 years on, he didn't really need this official function to have him made a legend of the club, because he's always been a legend of the club. And tonight he joins Charlie Sutton, the two inaugural legends in the Bulldogs Hall of Fame.
Well, you put a lot in and you worked real hard. There are days when you tried, days when you start, trying to please the crowds when they